This is cool to have in the shop.
Yeah, you're all good.
So I'm dating this girl, Heather, secretly. And the reason we are doing it secretly is because her dad is a teacher at the school. He's also the biggest, meanest, intimidating monster of a man you've ever met in your life. So we would often say, if you ever got in trouble, what he would do is he would take his, this is so gross, take his 10-foot dick and tie it around your neck and think of you behaving properly, which would give him an erection and cut your head off. That's like how afraid of this guy we were. One day, Heather and I, we cut school, we go to her house, and we're young, we're in love, we're having sex. We're knocking things over, because it's great. We happen to knock the phone off the ringer right when her dad is calling home from work.
Yes, God, Heather, yes!
Oh, true, take this, do that! Heather and I finish, and we're kind of reassembling the room. She puts the phone down on the receiver. Immediately, it rings. It's her dad.
I heard everything! Told her to stay where he is, I'll be there in 5 minutes.
Click, and it's full on panic mode. It is fight or flight, and I picked flight. I'm getting the out of there. She runs into the bathroom, and I'm leaning against the wall to grab like a shirt or something, and my finger is in the hinge, and she... Turns out she thought there was a towel like stuck in the door, so she's like slammed and slammed and slammed. Blood is now pouring down the wall. Eventually she opens the door all the way and I just like snatch at my hand. And I open my hands and this piece of my finger is in this hand. Seeing a skeleton is creepy. Seeing your own skeleton, nightmare. There's a hospital only a few blocks away. Her dad's gonna come home and kill me. So we just start running. We are running full speed. I'm spraying blood. And it's hard to run full speed like this when you're trying to hold your finger into your hand. So I'm running full speed like this. I'm spraying blood onto Heather behind me. We're running through a residential neighborhood, like past yards. People walking their dogs. Neighbors are wondering, what the f is going on? We get to the emergency room. We just run right up to the front desk. I don't even say anything. I just show them the dismembered finger. Oh my God, right this way. Doctors come in immediately and start rewiring my finger. I'm screaming, Heather's crying, the doctors are working on me. I'm about to throw up from the pain and blood. It's a mess. Anyhow, I get bandaged up. The next day, I have to go back to school. Her dad says, Drew, get over here. And I do this long, just like, death walk, walk of shame, knowing I'm gonna die. And I go up to him and I look up to him because he's so much bigger than I am. And he puts his arm around me and like squeezes a little bit. And I'm thinking about this 10-foot penis thing and I'm waiting for it to come out at any moment. He's gonna choke me out, I'm gonna die. And I'm just staring back at him and he leans in closer and whispers into my face, you're one of the family now. And just like accepted it. And after that, like, would invite me over for dinner, and Heather and I started dating, like, publicly. Come walk the dogs with me! And became, like, the cool dad. I guess all it took was his daughter to make him like me. It's a little crooked from the other one, but, like, barely noticeable.